Oh, right.
Yeah.
Okay, now it's been changed to.
Okay, yeah. Twitch,
Okay.
Shadows of Doubt. Well done,
okay,
well
there we, okay, yes. We're on YouTube.
Perfect.
Someone was on the ball. Somewhere. All looks good. All right. All right, yes, we're all good. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Post-CP stream. I'm Yancy Grosjean. I'm joined by Frost.
Hey, what a birthday present for me.
I know. And what an appropriate pairing for this particular game.
Right.
You got a very good voice for noir narration, we always think. Hence the cold take thing, I suppose.
Yeah, well, it's just a natural inclination. Unfortunate. I'm not even American.
Aren't you? I remain confused as to where exactly you came from.
No, I by my tan, given nature, I'm Mexican. I'm not from
right.
Here.
Okay, yeah. E1 Crazy for Life gets their first super chat in, $4.99, to say, I'm guessing the early access titles are not eligible nominees for the best, worst, or blandest list. Well, we'll have to see how the game's doing at the end of the year, I suppose.
I feel like you cursed it. You said you expect them to not patch out the good stuff.
I'd hope so.
I think you went.
And you know, as I said to you before we started, I'm a little bit paranoid this game's going to completely fuck up while we're streaming it, and no one will understand why I like it, and I'll be left sputtering with half-baked excuses.
Yeah, but there's two of us, so the odds of us both trying to gaslight everyone are...
I guess not.
Not zero.
You said you've been liking this game as well, haven't you?
I've been enjoying myself, absolutely. You said you hesitated. You were role-playing against your will. I think it takes a lot less for me to role-play into it. It just offers that.
Fair enough. I'm going to generate a new city.
Lovely. How about it?
I'm going to change the gameplay settings. What's that?
The default name, Jacques
no,
McCowan.
That's the name I always use.
Okay, so those are your saves I kept seeing.
Yeah.
All right.
And I'm going to give myself exactly $1 starting money.
Oh, I like
and,
it.
And you'll see why if it comes up.
Fantastic. You get to be a pauper private eye.
Yeah. This is how I like to play the game. Like, I'll play the game for a while, but after a while, there's even odds that something permanent will fuck up. Like, one time this weird visual filter, didn't go away.
Right.
I shut down the game and then restarted, and it still had that weird visual filter on, so I just had to restart the whole game from the beginning.
It's amazing. I've broken the game in a vent a few times. So
yeah.
I'm just stuck in the vents.
Yeah.
But all at once it works.
Yeah. There's plenty of ways it fucks up, but you know, it's early access. It's to be expected. This is a noir procedural voxel detective game. If you haven't seen today's review,
yeah, would you consider that style voxel? I don't know what they call it, really.
Yeah, yeah, it's totally voxel.
Yeah,
the 3D the 3D pixel style.
Yeah, yeah. So like you could see it in just the reflex of Minecraft to blurt in your head.
There was a time when voxels were going to be the next big thing. They were going to be huge because they allowed for 3D graphics without having to mess around with polygons. Or like the thing Doom did to make you think a 2D room was actually 3D.
Right.
But voxels, besides a couple of important games that used them, Outcast. I always get Outcast and Outlast confused. It was Outcast, yes. Outcast was a voxel-based open world game. I think Delta Force, some of the Delta Force games used it, and then everyone realized polygons were fine.
Yeah. Well, this to me is just a modern take on pixels, you know?
That's exactly what the voxels are. It's a pixel, but a three-dimensional one, and you just build the game like Legos.
Beautiful. I love it. Let's see here. As we load, have a read of these. Andrew Hickenbottom, £5. Happy birthday, Frosty. Here's £5 that's going to Nick/the company. Thank you, thank you.
It's your birthday today, is it?
Yeah, it's today.
Mine's in 2 weeks.
Look at that. I'll beat you to it.
Oh, damn you.
Asha Fisher, welcome to Early Access, and Dr. Zebra, member for 4 months Early Access. Hey, stink butts, love you. We love you too.
Yeah, I wouldn't worry about any of the story that the game's telling us right now. We'll all be forgetting about it once we've started the cases.
It's kind of like ad-libbed, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think. I got starch cola as well.
I think that's always the same.
Okay.
I think obviously all the character names change and the store names change. But some things about like the backstory of the setting are kind of fixed, I think.
Love it. What was your I wonder if we had the same start, because me, I just got a weird phone a weird message under my door. So I was on the phone for the first hour just trying to get somebody to pick up.
Yeah. That's the tutorial, I think. I just generate a sandbox game, so we have to like find our own way until the first murder.
How you feel about the systems, like the board, the plotting courses, all that, how it allows itself to be played, how it keeps track of stuff for you?
Yeah, I like all that. Oh, we've started the game pissing up a wall, it seems. What an appropriate beginning for our down-on-his-luck detective man.
You did give him a dollar, so...
Well, the reason why I got a dollar, because the first thing you have to do is look for a job at, like, a board next to a phone. But most of the jobs need you to call someone to get the job, and if you haven't got a dollar, you can't use the payphone.
Right. Oh, okay.
So I give myself $1 in case I need to call the client for the first job.
You don't break into people's places to use their phone? I do.
Aha. Here we go.
There you go.
Stolen item. That's a good start.
Oh, that's nice. I like it. What we got here? Darren Dodger Esquire, 1999. Birthday money for Frost. Now go do something regrettable with it. Okay.
You do that. Yeah, the other job was anger issues, and I think you need a camera for those ones. They're the ones where you have to smash something up, and you have to take a photo of what you did to get the payment.
I love it. So involved, really. I think the premise is brilliant, given the nature crime. It can just be random interactions, opportunistic violence, whatever it is.
Yeah, sometimes you just get mugged.
Yeah. Sometimes you just get shot. My guy got shot as I was going to collect him. I was waiting outside in the hallway. Somebody banged on the door and went in and murdered him.
That I've never seen that. That would be very cool.
That was unfortunate, anyway.
Okay, our first job. Someone stole an authentic prop gun from Mr. Quincy McCollum.
Nice.
Must we better go to his address and investigate the crime scene.
Beauty.
Here we go.
Yeah, now that board in particular.
Okay.
I love it.
And the side objective for this one is kick down the door of whoever stole it.
A little intimidation, eh?
Yeah. Well, sometimes I've done a theft investigation, and the side objective was throw a load of trash around in the perp's house as revenge.
Just to leave a message.
Where are we? Amazing. Floor 6. So every single apartment in every building is freely explorable.
Yeah.
And most of them can be accessed by vent crawling.
Or lockpicking the door, or breaking in through the windows. There's many routes.
It's almost like it's an immersive sim.
People don't know what those are yet. There's no definition of them.
Just tokenly check under the mat. Every time now.
Yeah.
Looking for the key. Let myself in.
Yeah.
Oh, hello. I didn't realize I was interrupting a party.
Oh, okay.
All right. So we've got Quincy McCollum. We've got his fingerprints. So we can check around the crime scene. And it's always stolen by someone they know.
Obviously. We got here, Steve Horwath, $10. Yahtzee, what game with a buggy PC port did you enjoy playing the most this year?
I guess I would say Jedi Survivor is the first one that springs to mind.
There you go.
You. Little... Who are you? You live in the crime scene. I need to know these things.
What have you seen? Oh, no. Nothing.
Man, your boyfriend's an asshole.
Why don't you grease his palm a bit?
I haven't got any money. I had $1 and I spent it on the call to get this job.
Well, I always ask for spare change.
Okay.
Well, I paid a guy off 50 for information and then I asked him for spare change and he slammed the door in my face.
Oh, wait a second. We got a murder. All of a sudden, I didn't notice.
What now?
Man, I was just about to start investigating a theft and suddenly there's a murder.
Mm-hmm.
Well, might as well inspect the crime scene.
It's just like Columbo. Starts off with a mild murder.
Okay,
fingerprint gun.
Yeah, check the fingerprints. We've got Mr. Murphy's fingerprints on the safe. Obviously.
You keep on scoping around and I'll read some more of these. Fungus Finder, $10. Yahtzee, finished all the past post ZPs. The random raspberries were fingernails on a chalkboard to my ears. Guess you'll likely do one now despite us. Frost joins side quest as a high-pitched gnome. Oh. High-pitched gnome, very specific.
Just always check the light switches for fingerprints, I find.
Oh, and you have to rummage through the trash. Don't forget about that.
Oh, we've already got the identity of the other person who lives here.
Yeah. Good old Calvert Murphy, eh? Lovely.
Okay, we've got type C fingerprints on the doorknob. And type D just underneath. And type E. Oh, I guess these guys are popular. So that probably doesn't help as much.
It doesn't. High trafficked area? No.
Yeah. So it was ostensibly stolen from the bedroom.
Do we have a flashlight?
Yeah.
Do we really? I couldn't find one for the longest time, so just bumbling around in apartments trying to slap the switch.
Here it is.
Oh, look at that.
You just press the middle mouse button to turn it on.
Fuck me. Of all the things.
Okay.
Employment contract. Mr. Quincy McCollum. What does it say he works at? I know, that's just his lease. Yeah.
The Salty Laborer Grill.
Okay.
And his roommate or boyfriend or something works at the Rampage Carnivore Grub.
Mm-hmm.
Again, these are probably randomly generated business names.
Yeah, no, none of them ringing a bell. Hey, Karuta Cowboy.
Just going to fill out our profiles by looking through their personal documents.
What was it? Karuta Cowboy, member for 34 months, bonus content. Yahtzee, which book of yours do you personally think is the best? I've only read the two Jack McCowan books, and so far, like the first one most.
Well, whenever anyone asks me that, I'm going to say my most recent book, because I need to pretend I'm constantly getting better.
There you go.
So why don't you check out Existentially Challenged, now available in Audible, ebook, and paperback from all good retailers. Aha! Type C returns. Type C is now being found on the drawer in the bedroom. That's a good sign. We have an unaccounted for fingerprint at the crime scene, people. Now we can continue the rest of the investigation. Man, it's all over these drawers. This must have been where it was.
That's because the lights were off, just fumbling around. Oh, what's this?
Okay, like? Our passcode for CM is Quincy's year of birth.
I love those, but there's a lot of forgetful NPCs that put there. Remember your password is blah, blah, blah.
Okay, this one's count backwards for mate.
Oh, all right.
All right, well, we've got the front door key at least. Now, standard practice, just gonna... Hang on. Yeah. Just gonna check the email, see if there's any relevant recent interactions. But now that we've got the fingerprint, the first thing I'd usually do is go to both parties' workplaces. look for the employee records that have all the fingerprint details and see if there's a match.
Fair enough.
Okay, we need Quincy's birth date, which is 1955.
Look at that. What do you know?
Look at that. We're investigating.
What's this, then? Dr. Zebra, $5. Frost, you're very handsome and your voice soothes my soul. Happy birthday. Yahtzee, are you not technically a hairy dad?
I am absolutely a hairy dad, since you ask. You know, this game, it needs to come up with different random emails for lunch dates. Every single one of them has the same text. I miss you like eggs miss ketchup.
I think it's because they don't anticipate you going through the same, like, the computer every time.
Well, what do they think I'm going to do? I'm an investigator. I got to turn over every stone.
That's fair, yeah. Especially like, if this is your job, you would have a process, wouldn't you? So
yeah.
You figured that would be noticeable.
Well, I should probably check the other guy's profile as well.
Do they all have computers? I think the one I had didn't have one.
Some people don't.
Okay.
Although most apartments do. Count backwards from 8, I believe it was. All right, now I've got the passcode, profile. Da-da-da-da.
Adorable. Look at that. LOTRFan193, member for 2 months, tip jar. Thank you. And MaxKO, $5. The more you guys describe this game, the more unbelievable it sounds. But it's essentially real life. You are Batman.
What's all this? An apology email from Annabelle Springer. I think Annabelle just became a person of interest.
I think she's got motive. Cringe emails. Oh yeah, doesn't want anyone to see them.
Just to add that to the mood board. All right, well, off to the workplace as it is.
I love it. Do you ever find chatty NPCs? Mine really don't like talking to me.
No, I had that encounter. I have that experience as well. Yeah, most of them just clam up instantly. Every now and again, you'll run into someone who just instantly will tell you their name and immediately let you fingerprint them and anything you want. But those people were like once in a blue moon.
Right. Amazing. I imagine like with the premise here, that's when they're just going to start adding more systems. Like try and be a bit charming to the restaurateurs or something.
Well, nothing in the bins.
No.
Yeah, I said in my review. I think NPC interaction would be an important thing to focus on for the developers going forward.
Love it. Yeah, just checking the fridge for clues, are we?
Yeah. Well, I try not to steal milk from people's fridges anymore because I threw up doing that once.
Yeah, what are you doing stealing foreign dairy?
Okay.
Oh, that's a good point. Slip Chicken asking, do you know if social credit impacts conversation reactions?
I do not know. You'd think it would. Conversations would keep getting easier because social credit only goes up.
Right.
But that hasn't really been my experience.
Right.
Let's see if there's anything in the safe.
Are you a good detective? Are you fairly good at this game?
I've had a pretty good track record. Once you understand the patterns, fingerprint in the crime scene is like always the perp.
Do it.
Hey, I was using that door.
You're stuck in here with him.
Okay, well, doesn't want to tell us anything.
I don't trust
this. Do you know Annabelle Springer? You work with them, do you?
Co-workers?
Don't suppose you have their fingerprint records on hand.
Looks like we're going to the salty grill.
I won't ask for spare change. I'm not that kind of detective. I'll steal spare change from people's drawers if no one's looking, but I'm too proud to ask.
I only steal enough to cover the fines for trespassing. That's it.
I don't think I've ever actually been fined. I mean, it says, like, I'm wanted for 100 credits right now, because I've stole stuff. But I don't think I've actually been made to pay it.
I think that's if the cops find you. I tend to just jump out a window.
Yeah. There's a Deus Ex-style cyber upgrade that removes fall damage altogether.
Oh, okay.
Which would be very handy on such a case.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, you didn't. I don't know if you mentioned that. You have the cyberkinetic upgrades.
Yeah, and they work exactly like the ones in Deus Ex, where you pick one of two upgrades from the from the thing. Oh, I'm wet now.
Yeah, means you got to break into somebody's bathroom and use their towel.
Yeah, I actually do that.
Yeah.
Or I use the shower because I gotten stinky from rifling through the bins.
Yeah, I went up through the vent, through the entire thing, loud, waking people up, and they just go, "What's that sound? What's that smell? What's that sound? What's that smell?" Unfortunate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's weird how NPCs keep looking for you AI activated even when they're handcuffed.
Yeah, when they're handcuffed.
So they're saying, "What's that sound? There's someone in my house." While after you've just handcuffed them.
Very astute of them.
All right, here we are at the salty whatever it was grill.
Look, have you tried causing distractions or anything, making a scene elsewhere? I'm not sure if that worked well.
I don't think that's ever worked for me.
Yeah. I was trying to get into one room, and so I wanted to create a divergence, so I broke into the other one and beat everyone up. I started just making as much noise as possible. No one ever showed up.
Oh, I can't afford a guest pass to pretend to be the health inspector.
Oh, man.
Guess we're just going to have to try to break into the employee records room.
Oh, through the vents. That's just a Gatling gun, you know, as you do.
That's not a vent, that's a Gatling gun.
Yeah.
It's no help at all.
Important thing is it's also not a camera.
Well, there's one.
Ah, damn.
Venti vents. Man, that graffiti artist sort of gave up unnecessarily at that point.
No, they just added the wall afterwards, you know.
Aha, a back door.
Da, 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 da. Oh yeah, this kind of misses music.
Door bugger.
Oh yeah. Alright.
What have we here?
Is that vent even attached to anything?
That one? To the ceiling, I assume.
Okay. What we got here? Is that phone records or employee records?
Phone records.
Okay.
I think the employee records are inside.
Oh, yeah, it is getting asked a lot. Were you wearing your old trilby while you were playing this?
Of course I am.
Uh-huh.
Get some information. There's old Quincy. There's Annabelle Springer, the one that was apologizing to us.
There we go. We know what she looks like now.
Aha!
Climb the vent.
Trying to be inconspicuous as I do this.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I wish I could throw things and cause a distraction somewhere else.
Man, a vent above the kitchen counter. That actually makes sense.
Yeah, that one would be absolutely grotesque and greasy. All clear.
Oh, I've been locked in. If only they knew. Oh, shit.
There's a camera. I feel like they know.
Shit.
Yeah, just run. You'll be fine. Wide Veed member for 21 months. Early access. Happy birthday, Frost. Thank you. 30 never looks so good.
Man, I just want to rifle through the employee records.
Yep. All right, yeah, just time it right.
Okay, go.
You can do it, there you go.
Shit.
You get caught again.
There weren't any employee records in that filing cabinet.
Oh, it's not a filing cabinet, is it?
Yeah, this one is.
Oh, okay.
Okay, we'll just wait for the camera to move and then we'll try over there.
Oh, we're about to get shot.
Shit. Okay, you know what? Next time, I'll probably just use the security box.
Yeah. Disable the power for a bit.
Boom. I like to think I've got my legs splayed out like Sam Fisher in this vent right now.
Very much so. This game has a way of making you feel like Professor Clouseau.
Oh, for God's sake.
Now there's more people. They're having a meeting in here.
Oh, God. It's almost like this is a workplace or something.
Damn. What if you've come across a diamond sting?
What I really need is the key to the other room.
Well, there were two keys in this room. Are they still in there?
I think so. Made a bit of a mess of this.
I think so, yeah. Might want to turn the power off. Oh! While they're in the room, all right.
No! No, bugger! You saw nothing.
No. You're gonna become some kind of some folk story. The cryptid that lives in the vents.
I'm a mysterious ghost. I'm a mysterious, smelly ghost.
Yeah, haunts the kitchen.
You know what? Let's just come back and break into this place at night when no one's around.
Yeah, that's nice.
Let's start investigating this murder instead.
Yeah.
Bye then.
Just leave without paying.
Or indeed buying anything.
Yeah.
Like an asshole.
Well done.
Okay.
Alright. They're gonna put up a new sign for you. No loitering, no jumping through the vents.
Okay. So the murder was on Shuster Street.
Right. Is that where we were?
Yep. Right. Let's find where that is.
We got here. Patar Fui Fui, member for 18 months. Bonus content. Immediately picked us up after seeing the ZP. It sounds right up my alley.
It's an acquired taste. Some people don't like detective games.
Right. Or immersive sims. Or voxels. Sims.
Or voxels.
It's funny that you seem to have the same guilt I have, where I don't care if I say somebody's favorite game is trash, but if somebody spends their hard-earned money on my recommendation for a game I enjoyed and it doesn't deliver, I feel way more pressure.
Yeah, I'd feel bad about that. Especially if it was a game I made.
Oh, okay.
All right, here's the corpse. Oh, it's one of these. Workplace murders. First things first, look at this obviously suspicious business card planted by the killer. Inspect the fingerprint. This is almost certainly the perp.
Nice. Wait, was that like a weird suicide note?
I've seen this like many times over. This specific thing. A business card with a cryptic message on it.
Yeah.
All right, let's inspect the corpse. Take their fingerprint.
We own like three jobs at the same time here.
Just the two.
The prop gun. Wasn't there two murders? No, just the one.
We were investigating a theft.
That's right.
Of a prop gun.
Prop gun.
Okay, so we've got the ID of the victim. And their fingerprints do not match the fingerprint on the business card, so the fingerprint is obviously belongs to the killer.
Organ donor.
Technically we should search their home, but considering the fingerprints on a business card, I'm liking jealous rival at work as a theory. Looks like they were bludgeoned to death. So we're gonna go straight. So we'll go straight to the workplace on this case.
See, this is lovely. I feel like the cop on his first day, and even though you're gaming the system, story-wise, you just have a lot of intuition.
Yeah, and you know, often a lot of murders are the same.
Yeah, I wonder if they have random events like a serial killer.
Whoa! This lady's carrying a rifle.
And they still got her.
I think I'd better take it with me.
Yeah. Also, don't forget to save.
Oh, Jesus Christ!
What?
What the hell happened there?
Well, you passed out, apparently. I don't know.
I think everybody around me was getting angry that I picked up a gun from a corpse.
Did they panic? He's got a gun.
I feel sick. I can't pay medical fees.
Yeah.
I guess I technically could.
Oh, okay, you fine. Paid him. Crazy.
Okay, fine. Okay, fine. We won't steal any more guns. Sorry, everyone.
Let's see.
I did pick it up though. Just check it for fingerprints.
What was that? Type what?
That's just Laquetta's, the victim's fingerprints.
So far, chat, we've been chased out of a kitchen, and we've been beat up for picking up a gun from a corpse.
We are not a very good private detective. But it's all, that's probably why we only had $1, but we're going to turn it around now.
Fate will smile upon us yet.
Okay, let's investigate this murder. Not our own murder yet. Oh, so we still need to pick up the murder solving form.
Oh, that's right, yeah. Why don't you give them a look at that? What they're supposed to be filling out.
Okay. So we need to figure out the full name of the killer. We have to arrest them. We'll need handcuffs for that. In fact, why don't I pick some up while I'm here? We need evidence that places them at the crime scene, so the fingerprint we found will do the job. We need their address, and we need the murder weapon, which is usually the hardest part for me. Because if it's not just lying around in their apartment, I'm not sure where else to look.
Can you torture it out of them?
That's never really occurred to me.
All right.
I got my handcuffs.
Yeah.
Let's go to the workplace.
We're just playing the split subconscious of one detective here.
Yeah. Unfortunately, our blood is all over the crime scene now, so that's going to confuse future investigators.
It's a little tainted. It's a little bit disturbed. I do like how they have some apartments that are the really nice, classy ones, and then you do have the slums as well.
Yeah, and the hideous basement apartments.
Little detail. Wow, why is it always flooded?
Because that's basements in dystopian cities, I suppose. It's what happened to the Airbnb when we were in Milwaukee.
Oh, okay. It was set in Milwaukee then.
The basement flooded at one point.
Yeah. Makes you stinky and then you have to shower.
Alright, here we are at whatever it was called. Looks like it's closed, but that's fine. We'll just see if we can vent crawl our way in. Ah ha 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 ha!
You're right in front of the camera.
Yeah, get a good look, Mr. Camera. Although that vent there might be a better prospect.
Yeah. No one will say anything, right?
No, people only start looking at you when you're actively in the place where you're suspicious, and they can't see you when you're in a vent.
Right.
So all the time you're getting in the vent, they're just going, oh, that is the normal person who is supposed to be there.
Yep. There you go.
Oh, that was bloody lucky. I'm in the records room already.
Look at that.
Although this camera is indelicately placed.
Yeah. What was the code for that?
0979.
Alrighty.
I suppose a security box is too much to ask.
Yeah. Do other investigators exist and can they interrupt your investigations? I don't think so, but that'd be cool. Rival investigators?
Well, since, apparently literally anyone can investigate crimes if they want,
true.
You might expect that to happen.
Yeah.
Just trying to find a security box. Ooh, free dosh.
It's not free if you're stealing it, is it?
I guess not. Five-finger discount. More free dosh.
Self-checkout. There you go.
Okay.
Lovely.
Okay. We're looking for a security box. Aha!
There it is. How many picks do you have on you?
None. Bollocks.
Now we have to look for hair clips and keys and such. Oh.
Double bollocks. Oh, well, there's a paper clip.
You need two of them.
This is why it's nice to be able to turn off the security system.
Yeah. Do you have a base of operations? You can in some runs. Like, you have an apartment.
Yeah, you can buy apartments as well. And this, you can even, like, choose to start with one already bought for you.
Yeah, like in this one, he just decided to live on the streets.
Yeah, because that's the kind of story I want to tell.
Rags to riches, private eye.
Okay, if we could just find one more paperclip, we'll be golden.
There we go. Yeah, they don't buy us because we're cheap. Oh, no, they do. Not because we're good, because we're cheap.
Shit.
Do you think this could have done with some ambient music?
What, for when you're infiltrating a place?
Just in general.
Yeah, I guess so. Bit of the old Deus Ex. Aha! A hairpin.
Nice.
I've scraped up a total of 2 shitty lockpicks, and now I can do one thing.
Lovely.
Alright. Security off. Now we can all breathe a little easier. As we hunt for the employment records.
Lovely.
Aha! First drawer we checked.
Oh, I love it.
Now it's all coming up Yahtzee. Alright, so we're looking for fingerprint type F.
Okay.
Oh, this is getting too easy, game.
Well, you still have to find the murder weapon and all that.
Maria Hudson, the corpo killer. She's ambitious, apparently. Aren't they all?
Mine kept being too flirtatious, I think. Everyone I found.
All right. Well, that was the hard part. What can you tell us about Miss Hudson, workplace computer?
Damn.
Well, someone forgot to put fresh paper in the printer, it seems, so we're on our own.
Can you put paper in the printer?
No, I think the game just fucked up.
Yeah. That'd be great.
Have you found anywhere you can sell stuff?
No. I have not.
I think one time I was playing and one of the locations was a pawn shop. I don't think I ever tried like selling things there.
Right. No, see, I love this game. I'm not good at it.
Hang on, let me just see if there's a pawn shop. Nope, not in our address book.
Also, if you know, if you're always eating, if you break into places just to eat their food, you don't really need money.
So, let's find Maria Hudson's desk.
Alrighty.
That's Alana Harmon. Maria Hudson, this is it.
Scan for fingerprints.
Well, we already know her fingerprint, and it was the one at the crime scene, so it's almost certainly her.
What if she was forced? What if there's an extra set?
Okay, here's a letter noticing that she's on probation. Ah, she left her computer logged in. What an amateur. And her code written down next to it. It's like she wants us to find all her shit.
It could be a trap.
Except this game isn't that sophisticated.
Yeah, imagine.
All right, there's the address. Oh, she lives in a basement. Well, we can see why she's ambitious.
When you're at the bottom, the only place to look is up.
I'm just curious to know if I can get the printer to work on this computer.
Maybe. Camden Ninja, $5. Could this be the forerunner to a whole genre of procedural sandboxes? The inverse, you have to find and murder a target and get away with it.
Ooh. A Columbo simulator.
Right.
Yeah, I'd be all over that.
That'd be lovely. I think, I wouldn't say it's going to be a new wave, but it's definitely going to inspire a lot of ideas. Because this is the kind of stuff that takes up so much time, but if you're just procedurally generating it, you can work on the fun stuff.
Well, I keep doing that. Okay, well, we've got Maria Hudson. I think we have her address. Yeah, basement 1, Wick Suites.
Wick Suites.
So now we just have to find her, arrest her, and steal all her shit.
In that order. Really, we steal everything first?
I just want a convenient way to be able to, like, select her address. That would be lovely. But the game's not giving me it.
Oh, you mean?
I mean, on some documents you can click on the address and it just creates an extra item for it, but I can't on this. Oh, I can't just from clicking on the profile there. Maybe I can do it with her employee records.
There you go. Makes it even more thorough.
Now her address isn't on here. Oh well. Well, we know the address. We'll just type it in. Like a barbarian.
Like a pilgrim.
Wick Suites.
Did they put a phone number in, you think?
I think we could probably find it. There's not much point in calling it at this point because we already know she's the killer.
Just to make her sweat a bit.
Yeah.
Let her know we're onto her.
Oh, man, there's tons of free cash in here.
Free money, you know, business. They just give it out with the lollipops.
Where's the vent we came in here? There it is.
Wait.
Yes, oh. right okay. There.
I like the idea of the social status mechanics in this game. Is it always murder, or do we have the occasional cheating spouses?
No, it's either murder or theft you have to deal with. Sometimes like side gigs usually involve finding someone from a small amount of details, and then you either take a photo of them, or beat them up, or arrest them, or steal something from them. Yeah. But, you know, they all basically start with looking for someone. Wait, man, this is probably the wrong way.
You can press tab and it shows you.
I don't know where... Well, not on mine, apparently.
Apparently not, no. Oh, God, you're going to do what I... Oh, nice, you made it, I think. That's a safe, neutral bathroom for you, yeah.
Huh.
Yeah, you're good.
There we go. Oh. Now we'll just need to arrest the perp. And our first murder is solved. We can get back to that great, exciting theft we were doing.
The prop gun. It's all connected somehow. Probably not. It'd be nice to dream.
Just another story of the Naked City. Yeah, I've done the humiliation ones as well, Slip Chicken. That's where you have to throw a piece of food at someone's face, take a picture, and leg it.
How much does that pay?
Usual sorts of rates.
Does it depend on what you're throwing or just random?
No, it just says throw a piece of food at them, take a picture of their astonished face, and then usually you have to run away because they try to kill you.
Oh, as they do.
Right, time to take a dangerous killer off the streets.
Oh God, here we go. How dangerous could she be? Have you always had to subdue them violently, or can you just talk them down?
No, I think pretty sure you've always got to arrest them.
Okay. What's this? John Connor, Canadian, 550. Are all the cases cut and dry, or is there any Witcher style you have to read into it and find out who the real baddie is? The first one.
Not really.
Yeah.
It's, as I say, it's more like a work-a-day private eye sim. And most times the story is pretty straightforward. But once in a while I'll get a murder where like the killer is trying to be like crafty.
Yeah.
The killer tries to taunt you by giving you their name in the form of an anagram. But then you just solve the anagram and catch them. It's actually quite a bit easier. It's like going after the Riddler. Look out, world. Here comes a man who's exactly as difficult to fight as anyone else, but slightly easier to catch.
Yeah, definitely easier to see in a crowd because of the green spandex.
Yeah. I think this is probably the address. We know it's a basement suite.
Yep, basement work suites. I mean, we could have called. Find out what room she's in.
Just in case I need to beat her up.
Oh, crikey. Is this the right one? Yep, that's her.
That's her.
Make nothing to deal with you. Oh God.
Can I come in and take a look around?
Before I beat you up. It's just so straightforward.
Yeah, this is what usually happens if you try to talk to people.
Yeah, do you know this person?
All right, guess I'm just gonna sock her in the mush the moment this conversation ends.
Yeah.
Da, da, da. Pow, 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 pow.
Not even it. Pow, she's not fighting back. Pow, just taking
pow,
it.
Pow,
God, that iron jaw.
Da, 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 da. Do da da la 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 la.
All right, now put her in the corner, and we gotta find the murder weapon.
All right.
She wouldn't try to run, would she? Are they capable?
I think they break out of their handcuffs after something like 2 hours.
Oh God.
Now, what could be a good bludgeoning weapon? Man, it could be fucking anything.
Could be. What's that?
Well, we found her purse. Ooh, some free money.
Yeah, I'm with Billy Bobby. The whole bed could be a bludgeoning weapon.
Chocolate bar? Did you beat someone to death with the chocolate bar or the birth control pills?
Birth control pills. We're hiding a pregnancy. Dun, dun, dun.
What's all this? Please, what he begged as the knife flashed in the light of the cruncher. Please, you can have the promotion. I danced around the office chair I had tied him to. Ha ha, I said, it is too late. You shouldn't have given the promotion to Jill. Now you will pay. He shrieked, but I took a print out of last quarter's fiscal report and stuffed it into his mouth. Who's underperforming now? I screamed. Well, if that's not a smoking gun, I don't know what is.
Maybe she's just a really bad writer.
Who leaves their fingerprints on a dead body.
Yeah, yeah. You know, method writer. Like a method actor, but they just have to get into it for when they're writing. Oh, why does she have files on her?
No, just the usual personal files. Tenancy agreement, workplace agreement. I think I'm just resigned to not finding the murder weapon.
Oh, wait a minute.
Occasion.
What's that? Work by said she likes sports. She had a baseball on her desk. There's no way it was that baseball on her desk, was it?
I very severely doubt it. I don't know how we'd be able to prove it was a murder weapon, even if... I guess there's a plunger here. Maybe that was it.
Plunged him to death.
Ah, fuck it. I don't know what the murder weapon is, but we don't strictly need to know what the murder weapon is.
Yeah, circumstantial.
Maria Hudson, the killer's arrested.
Oh yeah, can you search her?
We found her fingerprint. Oh, that's a point. Hang on a sec.
F. What are you looking for?
Opening the current location folder so that I can use it to select for the address.
Ah, okay. Well done.
All right, let's search her, see if she's carrying the weapon. She'd be very dumb to still be holding it, but I guess, tokenly. Oh. Well, that's what happens when you give people too much credit, I suppose.
We have too much faith in this city. It's rotten in the core.
Yeah, turns out we have located the murder weapon. All right, well, thanks for your time, Miss Hudson. Someone will come along to finish this arrest later, I'm sure.
No, that's good. Amazon Prime cops.
Yeah, you literally just handcuff people and leave them there.
It's amazing. Jacob Kirchhoff, welcome to Early Access. Thank you, thank you. No case too stupid for Yachts and Frost. There we go. Oh, that'd be funny.
I suppose if you're living in a basement and writing fan fiction about your murders, you're not the sharpest... tool in the box.
I mean, I suspected her to be a little unhinged, yeah.
You're not exactly Columbo villain material.
Yeah. Probably slept with the hammer and talks to it. That's what convinced her to do it.
Yep. Suppose we could have checked her locker at work as well. I forgot to after all that. All right, just submit the case. Da-da-da-da-da.
I think it'd be interesting to get some smaller cases, like a little girl hires you to find her missing cat or something.
Yeah.
That'd be nice. Except
how would you do that?
You'd look just for, go find a cat.
Look for cat footprints?
Sure. It's more so one of those cases that you know you kind of really can't do anything about. But hey, yeah, if you come across a cat.
Yeah, we'll let you know.
Yeah.
All right, the case of the Corpo Prowler. Case closed.
Well done.
And now back to the stolen gun thing.
Is it nighttime? We have to go back to the salty grill or whatever.
Yeah, it's 7 in the evening.
Oh, there's no way they're closed.
Oh, actually, since we just got some dosh, I'm going to buy myself a lockpick kit. Which is just 30 lockpicks. So that should make it a lot easier if we get caught out by locked doors again.
There you go. Great idea. Combine this with the Shadow of Mordor's nemesis system. Build up relationships. Suspects who come back get the revenge, get their own personal Joker.
Oh man, that'd be even more complicated and prone to fuck-ups.
Yeah. But that's what makes it exciting. Immersive sims that inspire imagination and efficiency. What we got?
The nemesis system is patented, as Dolan Duck points out.
Yeah, we'd have to call it something else. The rival system.
Oh, good. Nobody here.
Why is it closed at 7?
I guess it's not a very good diner. Or it's more of a breakfast place.
He said no one. Who's that?
Oh, yeah. He was so small, I didn't notice.
Just a small child. Where are your parents?
Okay, fine. I'll buy a guest pass so I can hunt around without being victimized by the security systems.
Guest pass at a freaking diner. All right.
Wait, you haven't given me an option to buy a guest pass.
Maybe get it from her?
You!
Sneeze. Is it going to need a guest pass to look around? All right.
Yes, can I buy one? Yes, here's the money for a guest pass.
There we go. Two hours.
Thank you.
It's like a parking meter. All right. Interesting.
What were we doing on this case? Yes, we'd found fingerprint type C. That's what we're looking for.
Yep. Calbert Murphy, prop gun. You also have to kick down the door or whatever when you find them.
Excuse me, could you unlock this door? I need to investigate.
Could you at least look away while I do it?
Oh, free paperclip. I'll have that. Oh,
why not? Is there a way to move time? I forgot if there was.
You can sit on a chair in like a bar and fast forward time from there.
We might have to do that till midnight because these guys are in the way here. Granted, if it's 24/7, that won't help you.
Where's that vent I used last time?
So, outside and around
there,
in it.
There it is.
Oh, there it is.
Don't mind me, just need to inspect your vents for E. coli.
Yeah, we got the health inspectors here. Highlighted, if you are wrong, does the game tell you, or can you still get monies for fingering the wrong folk?
The game tells you if you're wrong.
Yeah.
It's like Papers, Please in that respect.
There you go. Frost, will you be joining Yahtzee for Redfall next week? I don't know. I don't think that far ahead.
I found the key.
There we go. Yeah, why didn't you grab it last time?
Because I didn't have time, because I kept getting caught by things.
Panicked.
Don't think there's anything important the computer would be able to tell us.
No. Are those your footprints?
Code for the door would be nice to have.
I wrote a few down. I don't know if any of them work. 1955?
No, that was the other
dude's.
That's
his birthday.
Yeah, birthday.
Can you interrogate witnesses, says Billy Bob?
You can, but most of them are about as helpful as you've already seen.
Yeah.
Hey! Who are you? What? Oh. You're the janitor.
It's a broom. So they were holding a rifle, so I shot her. All right,
here's what we're after. Employee records. Yeah. Fingerprint type I, type J, type A. Oh, that's the guy we know. Who was stolen from.
Mm-hmm.
Type K.
Quincy, I believe. Yeah.
Type L. Type M.
Hello, type C.
Mr. Ennis Swanson.
Ennis Swanson.
I have a feeling something nasty is going to happen to your door sometime soon.
Where does he live?
Well, we don't know.
We could probably
find from the computer records.
Well,
if not, we could always just go to an address book, I suppose.
Yeah.
That's an option.
Ennis Swanson is type C. We're looking for him now.
Ennis Swanson. This one works.
Look, they put paper in.
This one doesn't give us his address.
But it gives his salary. That's nice.
I guess that's worth knowing, possibly.
Yeah. Or we could bribe him, maybe. With his own pay.
Lots of people reserving dinner at the Salty Laborer Grill. All right, back we go.
Back out. All right. Ennis Swanson.
Let's find his address with the phone book. Like some kind of primitive caveman.
When was the last time you saw a phone book?
I honestly can't remember. I guess it would have been on the floor in front of someone's house, having not been picked up or unwrapped at any point. Because nobody wants them. There's a phone book over there.
There you go. Wait, who... On that board of employees, who was he? What was his position?
Well, we'll find out in a second. Swanson. E. Swanson. Just the one. You ever had more than one entry when you've been looking for a name in the phone book?
In real life or in this?
In this, there'd be like two E. Swansons and I just have to check them both.
Yeah, just one. One time it happened to me where there was just two of the same name, and I go, well, flip a coin.
What's that? Dirty napkin.
Nice.
Right, where's that employee board?
Yeah, what'd that say? You love that 101... whatever.
Ennis Watson is just waitstaff.
Disgruntled, eh?
Yeah, they're all just waitstaff. Neither of them are the manager, it seems.
No cooks, only waiters.
Okay. Wait, did I actually write down Ennis Swanson's address after all that?
It was 101 something. I didn't see the whole thing.
Oh, bloody hell.
Look what you've done.
Oh, there it is. 101. What's its face? Park.
What was that?
All right, let's break into his home and rifle through his possessions.
On the way we go. Do we have handcuffs? No, we don't have to handcuff this guy.
Well, it might, if he's there in his home, it might help to handcuff him.
You could just knock him out.
But he'd wake up pretty quickly if you do that.
Oh. See, I'm on a budget here.
And we are supposed to kick down his door, of course.
Fair, yeah.
Okay, level one.
Are we? I think we're on that floor.
Fingers crossed. Did he put his key under his mat?
Are we going to break in or are we going to knock and let him open the door to his fate? Damn.
No keys.
No keys. Is there a vent nearby?
Nobody answering the door.
Oh, there's a vent right there. Kind of.
Knock harder. No,
did you test that out? That the knocking can get progressively louder as you keep doing it?
You can get more and more pissed off. Because sometimes it's because they're out, but sometimes it's because they're asleep.
Yeah.
I don't think I've ever woken them up.
There you go.
There's an electronic security box. Might as well turn the... I got lockpicks to burn. I'm just going to pick open his door. Right, switch off the security. Don't mind me. I'm the door inspector.
Yeah, just a lot of inspecting today. What would have been so funny if you ran out of locks because you used it on the security system.
Nah, I bought a lockpick kit. Not much to worry about.
Yeah. Lovely.
You saw nothing, whoever you were. Huh.
What? He hasn't paid the light bill?
His lights aren't working. Oh, there we go. All right. Now I just have to find the stolen item.
You're not going to look to see if he's here.
Well, let's... let's not prematurely burst into his bedroom or whatever.
All right,
nothing in the cupboards.
Is that a vent? Oh.
Yeah, there's a vent sometimes going through people's cupboards.
Okay.
And looks like there's some important items behind it that I can't get to. Oh, well.
This, all right.
And we're looking for a prop gun.
In the trash, you think?
Ooh, hard cider. Yeah, sometimes people steal just to, piss people off as an act of power.
All right.
Oh, no, I'm stinky now. I'm stinky because I searched through the trash.
Use the shower.
Yeah. I'm going to have to use the perps shower.
Hello, what's this?
Oh, wait a second. Mina Hansen? There must be two people living in this horrible apartment. That's awkward.
We did see a lot of fingerprints. You think it was two people?
Now, there was only one set of fingerprints that was in the actual crime scene where it was stolen from. On the drawers. Ooh, free dosh. Okay, let's check the
watch bedroom. Be out.
Okay, nobody's in. That's good.
Not even already. Well, we'll still have to hunt him down somehow. Have you watched a videotape? I couldn't find a place to see one.
Okay. No, I haven't found any VCRs or anything. Passcode is the year M was born.
Who's M? Mina?
Yeah, presumably Mina.
Damn.
Aha. But Ennis isn't quite so smart. E413 is his code. Let's hope it's the code for that safe. Ha 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 ha! Bingo!
Oh, look at that.
I'll just double check. This is the thing we're after. Yep, it's got Quincy's fingerprints all over it. This is the very one. So now we just have to pop it in Quincy's mailbox and break down the door of this apartment.
Just to be thorough. And it wasn't even here. That makes it easier.
No.
Nice.
Yeah, well, it always makes it my job quite relaxing.
Yeah. Can you just play this game as a straight burglary simulator while ignoring the cases? You could, but you don't get any rewards or anything, aside from, I guess, the joys of kleptomania.
Yeah, just steal people's money and make a living that way. What's a good thing for smashing a door with?
Take your own story. A prop gun. You're going to hurt yourself.
Yeah.
Maybe we should have taken the hammer from...
I was just thinking that. I was hoping I could use the wrench as a melee weapon.
I
can attack with the prop gun.
Oh. Shoot it, maybe.
No, it doesn't. It's a prop gun. It doesn't fire.
Oh. Seems to not be sturdy enough. Are you knocking with it?
You know, I just wanted to make sure.
Run into the door and knock. Like sprint and knock.
I'm just thinking if there's a button for kick.
Yeah, it could be, yeah.
That would be helpful. Man, I've been dicing with death because I haven't saved once.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna quick save now.
Frost is taking notes, I see. They should make it a Patreon goal to have these two fellows play detective games together. I always love note taking for detective games.
Yeah.
As much as the
Although
ritual.
It's not usually that necessary.
No, it's not, but it's still fun.
Man, how do you kick down doors?
Is that no? We're only going to get paid half of it because we couldn't break the door. Yeah, people are saying you can sprint and right-click into the door to barge into it.
I did not know that.
We'll give it a go.
Well, it's can't get much of a run-up.
Well, what if you did it from the inside? Oh,
there it is. Hey! You know, I genuinely didn't know you could do that.
That's had an interesting combination of systems.
All right, well, that's the door kicked down. It was stolen by Ennis Swanson. The gun is recovered, so we just have to pop it into his mailbox at 604 Younger Towers. Bish bash bosh.
Boom, done.
This is going really well so far. Two crimes that fairly quickly solved. Didn't get hung up once looking for the fingerprints of the perp.
Lovely.
Because sometimes you just can't find them.
Does this work on Steam Deck? It almost kind of barely works on PC sometimes. I'm not sure.
Have any ever played mouse and keyboard? I don't know if how the controller controls are.
Yeah, I keep getting a weird bug here and there where everything just starts shaking viscerally.
Are you sure it's not because you're cold?
No, I was warm. I was indoors.
Well, sometimes you're still cold from being outside.
Maybe.
I forgot to take a shower.
Oh, that's
right. Well.
You stinky still. Next place we break into, we got a shower.
All right.
Is that your mail?
Now I just got.
Oh, it is. That's right.
Yeah.
Look at that.
All right. Now I just have to call the number, and we're done.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have a phone? I'm not buying anything because I'm an asshole.
Yeah. Well, do you always have to buy things when you go in somewhere?
Well, I feel like an asshole to just go in a store and walk around and leave without buying anything.
It just feels highly illegal to walk into a store and not buy something.
All right. Hey! It didn't count barging down the door.
Did it not?
Was that because we picked it open first?
Yeah,
we were supposed to kick it down as we arrived.
Yeah, it is a little strange that you did lockpick it and then break it.
Well, you know, if someone comes back later and finds it like that, they won't know that I picked it first, like a like a twat.
Like a gentleman you are.
All right, we can close that case now.
Look at that. Boom.
All right, let's pick another case.
We're going to be in the nicest apartment by the end of the day.
Public humiliation.
Public urination.
Humiliation, you silly. Oh. Photography. Demolition.
Photography. Have you got a camera? Yeah. I think they'd enjoy seeing that one.
Yeah, I should probably get a camera. Outsourced arrest. Public humiliation. Ah, business concern. This is usually the one where you have to steal an envelope from someone's workplace.
All right.
And more public humiliation.
Mm.
All right, let's buy a camera.
A lot of humiliation in this town.
Let's buy a camera from City Hall, wherever the hell that was. There it is.
Yeah. By the way, Frost and Yahtzee, how far have you gotten in the game? It's a sandbox. We've made some money.
Yeah, I just keep going.
Yeah. Usually that's like the 1.0 inception for these kinds of games. When full release comes, there's a story.
Yeah. Although it's sort of a tutorial mission that to settle you in.
Yeah, but that does have some background.
Yeah, but then it just goes to random crimes.
Yep. Dr. Zebra, $2, preferred men's underwear. I think I wear Hanes, a lot of Hanes. Boxer briefs, very...
Yeah, I'm a boxer brief man, too. In fact, I think I'm also wearing Hanes right now.
Look at that, we're actually the same person.
I've got some others from different brands. Because who the fuck is loyal to their underwear brand?
No, not me. As long as it's got sweat wicking, that's all you need.
Alright, let's buy ourselves a camera.
Lovely.
Although people get really pissed off if you go around holding it up.
I mean, they get whiny if I'm just... Yeah, see? They get whiny if I run by them.
Yeah, but they'll start getting aggressive if they see you holding a camera.
Oh, okay. That's strange.
Well, now we've got a camera. Let's check the job board over here.
There you go.
Destruction, photography, public humiliation.
There we go. Saying, why does this character feel like the main character of Disco Elysium? Because it's us.
Yes. Yes. Hobo detectives.
Yeah.
This dude, Disco Elysium dude, and Rorschach. They should all just get together.
Yeah.
Gather around to burning bins on night.
That's the fun of it. If you ever do get bored, you could try to challenge yourself to be a clean, proper detective, you know?
Yeah, well, that's what I did at one point when I was in, like, my roleplay groove. At one point, like, I was trying to do a burglary mission in that I was doing the burglary. Got surprised by the resident, panicked, jumped out of a window, broke both my legs, and then decided that my character was going to resolve to only do legal missions from now on.
Love it.
He'd seen the light. Okay, let's do a public humiliation.
Oh, let's get it. And Team Boxer Breeze for the win. Thank you for the highlighted.
All right. Got to call someone.
See, I almost could see this game being a thing in the same way that, like, GTA RP is a thing. And DayZ. There's just roleplay stuff here and there.
Okay. Meet at the Salty Laborer Grill. I'm familiar with it.
Yeah, that's my favorite part of an immersive sim. It's just like, go to this thing, you know? Oh, I do know it. There we go.
I'm not sure exactly how to get there from here off the top of my head. Okay. Talk to the person sitting holding a cola in the Salty Laborer Grill.
Is that a pawn shop?
Don't think so. I searched for pawn earlier in the directory and there wasn't one.
Search for pawn. Okay.
There it is.
He starts to grow on you. There we go. Oh, you're going to have to buy another pass.
Dude with a cola.
Ennis?
I'm going to assume it's you.
Wait, is that Ennis? We just arrested... No.
What?
That's we're taking Ennis. A case from the man whose door we just broke down.
Are you sure?
He said his name's Ennis.
Well, I guess we didn't arrest him.
No, we didn't.
I guess we should be glad he didn't get a good look at us.
Okay.
Oh, no, that's not Ennis. That's an unknown citizen.
I just swear on me, Mum, it said Ennis. Someone go check the VOD.
Well, there's Quincy.
Yeah. But, you know, I suspect that would be a possibility, considering it is a living society, essentially.
Okay, let's see what we got. We've got a face.
Yeah. Find the guy that broke into my apartment and stole my stuff. Yeah.
Okay. Well, first we have to identify this person.
Oh, God.
And then we have to throw food in their face.
All right. Well, that means we also have to find food to throw.
Though, annoyingly, all we have is a photo.
No voice ID.
So,
maybe we ask him more questions.
Hang on, I'm just gonna... Just for the sake of deniability, just fling this briefcase into the sea.
Christ. What if you need it?
Probably won't. Already got the details from it.
All right.
I've never seen this before. I don't think I've ever had to identify someone from their face alone.
Nah.
I'm not quite sure how to do that.
I mean, it's very side questy. You know, it's probably just something that happens.
Yeah. I guess we'll just check the employee photos of every single workplace in town.
Well, yeah, see, somebody checked. They said, I'm Ennis from Salty Laborer Grill. Yeah.
Huh. Well, there you go. Awkward. There's got to be a smarter way to do this, but none springs to mind right now.
Well, you could show people the picture you have and hope that one of them knows.
Oh, that's a thought. Yeah, you could try that. I saw them somewhere around Gongville. Oh, well, that's helpful.
Look at that.
Thank you, person.
Nothing gets by us here.
Good thinking, Frost.
Small town. What you know?
Okay. Gong building, eh?
Gong building. Sounds like a strip club.
Sounds like a strip club with a procedurally generated name.
No. how frequently do murder investigations occur in Sandbox?
They come up every now and again. Every, like, day or so.
Those are the bigger ones. You don't really want to get flooded down with a bunch of murder.
Okay, we're in the Gong building. Not sure what to do from here.
Well, I guess ask more people.
Yeah, find more people to ask, I suppose.
Sure, yeah.
The one thing we could do is find the security computer, see if they've shown up on camera at any point.
Right. Oh, it's capable of that. That's cool. All right, to the security room we go then. Which is generally, like, near the basement.
Yeah. Oh, there's someone. Oi!
Oi, you.
Oi, you. Well, that doesn't help.
No. 5:15, what time is it?
They were near Metal Hardware Store, headed east. Okay.
What's the in-game time currently? We got... It's 22:15? Feck. That was so long ago. Think, hold on. Yeah, 10. It's 5 hours ago, and that doesn't help us. We're gonna find him, and then have to go find food, and then lose him.
Well, he's right. Well, that Metal Hardware store's right next to a food place.
Hmm.
Well, it's another place to check. I'm just gonna see if I can find a security computer.
Do you think everyone here has a job? Like, surely everyone works somewhere, no?
No, there are some unemployed people who just hang out at home.
Yeah, that's me.
Who are very annoying if you're trying to break into somewhere.
Yeah, clue is a clue. The tutorial even warns you some things can just be dead ends. Nature of the job.
I'm not sure where I am right now.
You just can't help but break into things, can you? We're looking for this man, and somehow we're looking for him in a safe.
Oh, for some reason I'm in a sink clinic. I'm in the Chapman Parade sink clinic records room.
Yeah.
Which isn't really where I wanted to be.
There you go.
Oh, shit.
Marauder.
Oh, I'm leaving. Leave me alone.
You saved so long ago. Run.
Damn, it's a tough life being a private eye in this city.
Yeah, broke as well. Get around the corner and save.
Oh, damn. They are relentless. And I'm still stinky. I keep forgetting.
Yeah. The Purple Marauder, member for 10 months, tip jar. Thank you, thank you. Let's see.
You! Random citizen.
Keep walking with you, creep. Okay.
I just wanted to say hi.
Take a picture, it'll last longer. Is your camera out?
No.
Oh, why would you say that?
I guess I'm just weirding people out.
I guess.
Everyone's telling us somewhere different.
Well, you don't expect him to move everywhere, do you? Or stay in one place, do you?
I guess not. I'm tempted to go back to just checking all the shops with the photos.
Maybe we luck out and one of them knows his name.
Man, I just want to throw food in his face.
Right.
Why has he
got to
be such an asshole about it?
Okay. Where's this this record thing you're talking about?
What's that?
You said the cameras keep track of who they see?
Yes, if you can find the security room for some places. This was covered in the game's tutorial, actually. But if you can find the security computer for a place. That doesn't look like a helpful place to be.
No. Your character's also thirsty.
Oh, so he is.
Stinky and thirsty. It's a hard life.
Okay. Don't want to be there.
The other Frost, your accent's perfect for this game. Which one, Ming? There we go. Doing a bit of a diehard. Oh, the janitor. Our mortal enemy.
It's always the janitor.
No.
You know what? I'm just going to keep asking around in the streets about this dude.
Yeah.
We'll just see if anyone says the same place twice.
Yeah, I weren't expecting him to be in the vents, really. Oh, nice. We need to find a drink, a shower,
you.
More info.
Do you know this person? Okay, Younger Towers.
There you go.
Another
two
one.
For Younger Towers.
Another person says Younger Towers.
So he lives there somewhere.
Let's hope so.
Is there a way to check for pictures there, you think?
Probably not.
Yeah.
But, you know, if he's got a neighbor who knows him, they'll be hanging around the same building, I assume. Mm-hmm. You! Talk to me! Don't walk away from me, you sack of fucking cum!
You smell and you have cotton mouth.
Is there a fucking... Yeah, like a newsstand. Get myself a coffee.
That's a diuretic. Just makes you thirstier.
Well, tell the game that.
Okay. Well, if the game's not going to abide by it, I won't either. Does that snow actually accumulate as it falls? Looks like it.
I was going to throw this coffee over the wall, but there's a dumpster here.
Wait, does that count as the food we have to throw? We probably should have grabbed the donut.
There'll be plenty of opportunities to grab some food once we've identified the guy.
Alrighty. Captain President,
$10. Okay, Younger Towers again.
There it is, three for him. Now I'm waiting for Yahtzee and Frost to abscond the escapists and start up a private detective agency together. Yep. So it's all the tax documents that do us in. Oh, is that a cop?
Oh, well, they're as friendly as a cop.
Yeah, what were you expecting from the law? Bribe them.
I guess not a whole lot. What about you? Are you friendly? Yeah, Younger Towers, everyone's saying that.
Definitely stays there. Highlighted. Coffee only makes you thirsty if you stop drinking it. Fair point.
Oh, there's 17 stories. If there weren't so many, I was planning to go door knocking.
Jesus. Worse than a Jehovah's Witness here. Hold your horses.
Hello. Gong Building again.
Okay.
And back to Gong Building.
No, we stay here and we keep asking. Because if we go to Gong, they're going to send us back to Younger.
Yeah, probably. Oh. And this one's choosing to be a twat. Okay, have some money. Have some more money.
Ask them for spare change now.
Oh. Well, thanks for the one coin, asshole.
What a generous man. Yeah, welcome. Yeah, zero preparations. That's a great title for a detective series.
Okay. Let's knock on some doors.
Yeah. Watch it be him, just randomly. Yeah, I know him. It's me. Are we not in Gong Building? Oh no.
No, we're in Younger Towers. Remember?
That's right.
All right, if one more person says Gong Building, we'll go back to Gong Building.
Right. And they're going to redirect us here, but it's still movement, you know? It's progress somewhere. Oh, hello. Your theory is he works in Gong Building and lives in Younger Towers. Interesting.
Well, this one says Younger Towers.
We're in Younger Towers.
You know what? I'm just gonna keep on with it. This is like grassroots police work right here.
Yeah, I like it. I like it.
Knock,
standardized.
Knocking on doors, asking for the dude. There.
Oh.
Am I interrupting something?
He knows a thing or two about Gong Building.
Yeah, fuck well, you then.
I guess not.
Ask that other dude I saw. You. Oh.
Oh. Oh, what? We got a name.
We've got a name. Thank you. Thank you, you bastard.
It works at a door group. Oh, well done, Yats. Your determination saw you through.
Oh, thank Christ.
Well done.
Oh, God, I hope my character wrote that down. Yes,
I've got it.
It's Konstantin Bondarenko. Now we just have to figure out his address and then rub some food in his mush.
He also works at a door group. If you're like, they would probably have his info.
Yeah, and it's best to do these things in public places, I think.
No, not door.
A door.
A D O R E. Yeah, there it is.
Younger Tower, second floor landing, eh?
Oh, so he does work in Younger Towers.
There you go. He might even be here right now.
Could be.
In which case, I probably should have picked up a donut to throw in his face when we had the chance.
We'll break into his place, rummage through his fridge, throw it at him, take a picture, leave.
Oh, a door group's in the Gong Building.
Oh. Okay.
Okay, so we don't get caught out again. Should we throw donut, croque monsieur, or yakisoba pan? That's really messy. That'll fuck him up.
You can't say that. We phone our job in. We commit. Off we go.
Oh, man. Just stumbling into one of his co-workers at random.
Hey, that's life, you know?
Classic stuff.
I wonder how big the city is and how many inhabitants there are.
I just followed the arrow. That looks like a workplace. A door group, Younger Tower, second floor landing.
Right. Is that where we are? Just follow the arrow.
Wait, why does it say Everett Boulevard on the bottom?
Oh.
Okay, there's a door group. It says Gong All right. Building.
Alright.
I'm confused.
Man, no one tell Yahtzee about Dwarf Fortress. We'll lose him forever. Have you played that?
People keep telling me to.
Yeah. I don't know how it will spark your imagination. Okay. Yeah, we'll see where the mysterious arrow wants us to go then. Hey, look, that's where we got beat up.
Yeah, memories.
Okay. Alrighty then.
Oh, this is a door group.
Yeah, because this is, yeah, this is the work area. Interesting. And now we vent our way in. Da-da-da. Da-da-da. Oh, that's not stairs. We're not very nimble.
Wonder if we could... Aha, we get onto the roof.
Convenient scaffolding. Oh. Oh, don't do this. Oh, it's part of the apartment complex, all right.
Yeah.
Okay.
But how to get in?
Well, then the vents are connected too. Wonderful. Oh, now we're hungry? We should have got two Yoko pans or whatever they were.
Maybe there's another way in.
Well, if you can't find it, I mean, why not?
Oh, hang on. Get myself a hot dog.
A vending machine wiener, yeah.
Yum, yum. Now that's dystopian.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I think this hot dog's finished, but it kind of looks still intact.
Give it to the homeless people, I don't know.
Do you want a burger?
That's a hot dog.
A hot dog? Well, what's the difference, really?
There's a whole thing about it. I'm not starting that one. Break the door open with the hot dog.
Do you think we could get away with picking the lock?
I think so, yeah, I generally do.
Oh, hang on.
What?
I had the key.
The key?
Somehow.
Oh, nice. Well,
top of the morning to ya.
Yeah.
Just going into my workplace that I work at.
Just testing the alarms at my workplace.
Yeah.
King Dead 42, $2. $2 for your own vending machine hot dog fund. Thank you, thank you.
You know, we got his name. Pays, we could have just gotten his address from the phone book.
Oh, that's true, yeah. And it's not like he has a special name. Oh, no, it is special. It's not unique. Nick the O, is it? Nick the OG, $5.
Shit, bollocks, 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 bollocks.
Oh, okay.
Right, phone book it is.
Oh, God. Nick the OG, $5. Haven't been able to catch one of these live in a while. Seems a pretty enjoyable game. Hope you're both doing well. Yeah, doing stellar. There we go.
Right, I'm going to smear the fuck out of this yakisoba pan in this dude's face.
Oh, God. Why didn't we start here?
I don't know. I think you said find his workplace, and I just went along.
You said that was an address book.
Konstantin Bondarenko, okay.
Yep. I imagine there's only one Bondarenko.
Yeah,
there he is.
What a name. And he lives in Younger Towers, what do you know?
I mean, did it say where in there?
Fourth floor.
Nice. Amazing. Younger Towers, fourth floor. I mean, how many doors would be on fourth floor? You just knock it.
I think we know the number.
How can this be harder than solving a murder? Well, we started with no clues, just a picture.
402, Younger Towers.
Nice, there we go. Narrowed her down, we did.
Oh, please God be home. So I can just stick this thing in your face damn. And run.
Yeah, what if he's out? What if he's working?
Well, we just went to his workplace and it was closed.
No, alright.
Oh, here we go. Save. Right. Quick save.
Slam in his face and take a picture. What if his son opens it up? Oh, God.
Well, that'll be awkward then.
Well, good thing we brought the hot dog and the yakisoba pan.
Hello!
Is that a gun? Oh.
Bye!
Thank you. There we go. We got him.
Throw some food. Job done. Oh, thank Christ for that.
Phenomenal. Look at that. Three jobs, one day.
Yeah. Everything's coming up, Jack McKeown.
How much did we spend, though, across the way with just food and all that? Might not pay much.
Well, we've made a net profit of 3,786 credits. Starting with one.
Started with a dollar. Look at that.
Yeah, look at me, Mr. Savvy Worker. Who remembers to steal all the change he finds in random drawers.
That's a lot of loose change you got there.
Someone must have a phone.
Just ask them for it. It's for a cell phone. No cell phones here. Oh. Yeah, everything's closed right now. Oh.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah.
What we got here? Perfect. Dalton Bland, $5. This is how I imagine Yahtzee approaching people in real life. If you must approach, always approach with a hot dog.
Yeah, that's some yakisoba pan to the mush.
There we go, check and check. Perfect. Another satisfied crime, I guess.
Sold! Oh, hello, Lily from Green Dragon. I'll just write her name down for future public humiliation purposes. Oh, apparently my social credit goes up from throwing yakisoba pan in people's faces. Good to know.
I suppose they deserved it. I don't know.
All right, let's check the jobs. Oh, there's a really shitty apartment for sale. In a basement somewhere. But I'm too proud for that.
Yeah, we're a nomadic PI. We live on the streets.
Oh, hold the phone. 4,000 credits?
For what?
Why, I could live like an emperor in Kansas City.
We don't know the exchange rate, though.
I forgot I needed to close this case.
Oh, yeah, it's still
humiliation,
annoying.
Case closed.
A friend of mine from school made this game. So proud to see you guys playing it. Go Cole, great job. He did pretty well, Mr. Dayfox. Yeah.
Well, there you go.
Got friend and family of the dev.
Hang on.
What was the objective here?
Ask the staff about McKenzie. I guess the job wasn't selected.
There we go.
Oh, I hate these ones.
Oh, boy. Hidden briefcase. Interesting. No, I'm running out of pen. Oh, there we go.
Well, can I have the photo then? Oh, there it is.
Yes.
Oh, that's a lot of help.
Wait. Is that not the bathrooms in the salty grill?
I don't think so.
Oh, yeah. Thought the graffiti looked familiar. It says Munn Street. That narrows it down.
Yeah. Looks like Munn Street's just a little alleyway. Yeah, shouldn't be too hard to search it.
Interesting. Then we get the briefcase. What's the end game like for this, or is it never ending? So sandbox mode, never ending, yeah.
Yeah. And it's still in early access, so there's no like critical path or anything.
Yeah. It's probably, again, it's probably like the Long Dark and all a lot of survival early access games where the story is the last thing they put in.
Why was I directed into this building?
I don't know.
Mr. Arrow.
I'm gonna make you leave now. What?
Can I just go this way? No. Yeah. Did you get
when's
mad?
The game, when's the game supposed to fully release? Don't know. I mean, it could be inside.
Where am I? I've lost myself. Oh, there I am.
Yeah.
Okay, just turn around and go this way and go around the back.
It's a very introspective game. Jason Foley, €5. Hey, Yachts, would you classify this game to fall into the do-anything category of games that you warned us about in extra punctuation?
No. It's got very clear gameplay loops. Yeah. You solve crimes. There's like a routine for doing them.
Yeah. It's basically, it's do one thing, but in varying ways.
I'm done with you.
Oh, they're not done with you. Oh, there's the hammer we could have used.
Biff. Oh. Biff.
What?
Biff. Hey, he broke my leg. Yeah, what an asshole.
Oh, everything's gone monochrome. And you're still stinky.
Yeah, I thought I'd have fit it right in. looks like planking's still in fashion in some places.
Alright. Still in fashion, this is where it came from. This is like 1920.
Don't mind me, just looking for a briefcase.
Can we sleep here?
Oh, there it is.
Oh, there it is.
Alright, well, let's look at the briefcase and then take care of our broken leg. All right, we're looking for an unknown citizen.
Oh, God.
With a specific handwriting. He's interested in baseball. His first initial is B.
Okay.
There's got to be more than that.
Wow, these are actually getting vaguer and vaguer.
Seriously?
Pasco,
is this all we've got?
Type J. Are we missing something? How many B names do you think there would be in this town?
Probably quite a few.
We don't have anything to show? Wow, that's crazy.
This really isn't anything to go on.
That's amazing.
All we have is an age.
53.
With that specific handwriting. Type J handwriting.
Type J handwriting, 58. What? Did the location have anything to do with it?
No.
No? It's just, there's the briefcase and this is the guy you have to publicly humiliate.
Identify this person, steal an envelope from them,
and
then follow further instructions.
All right, we can do it. Interest is baseball, though. How random.
Goodbye, briefcase.
Oh.
Now I need something to repair my broken leg.
Yeah. When you cook anything frozen, do you throw away the instructions and then need them later?
Yes, I do that all the time.
That's why you worry me with this briefcase.
I pick them out of the bin again.
Yeah.
Take me to a sink clinic. I've been hurt by a crazy man with a hammer.
You know what? We could maybe ask someone at the hospital if they know. Everyone needs a hospital.
Is there an easy way to, like, search for people by...
What
the hell? Leave me alone!
What are you doing that's illegal, being stinky in public?
And having a broken leg and being cold.
Yeah.
Now, what was that guy's problem?
I know, you just passed out, I think.
Maybe that was Ennis. Oh, hold the phone. A murder to investigate.
There we go.
Fortunately, being hospitalized cures you of being stinky.
How nice of them.
I happen to know. Oh, fine. Guess we'll pay them.
Just run for it. Leg it.
I want them to unstink me first.
Yeah,
there we go.
Where in Younger Towers was that?
I have no idea. Oh, wait, 402?
That was us. Did you kill him?
I didn't kill him. I just threw a thing in his face.
You killed him. He's dead.
Oh, man. I guess we got to check now.
Yeah. That's what I kind of like about it being an enclosed environment, is you start to know the people.
I'm so sorry. I mashed yakisoba pan in your face. If you've just died, you poor bastard.
We're going to show up to the crime scene, this chalk outline, and
just yakisoba pan everywhere. Saying, if we can find the person who did this, I think we'll find our man.
Of the murder, it's me. The Purple Marauder, 20 knock. I have to try this while enjoying a whiskey. The whiskey might help, yeah. Fucking hell. We gotta turn ourselves in. What now?
I didn't kill him. I just threw a thing in his face and ran like a cheeky child.
And then he slept and died on it. Have you located the murder weapon?
We know bread was involved.
Yep. Eat it. Eat the murder weapon.
Looks like he was bludgeoned to death with a soggy noodle.
It was a death by humiliation. Yeah, let's pretend like we don't know. It's like, oh, yeah.
That's the umber,
do you know
you
where
say?
402 is? What? I've never been here before. Oh my god. I swear if we killed Cornstarch Brendan Meister, whatever his name was.
It looks like shortly before the killing, a mysterious smelly person was asking about him from various passers-by.
Well, it's not us, for you see we're clean. Oh my god, you murdered him.
Yep, this is his house. Although, let's not jump to conclusions. I mean, he might live with someone. In fact, yes, that's not the person we yakisoba panned.
What if you pissed him off and then he committed murder-suicide? Is that a pagan symbol on the ground?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. All right.
All right, let's inspect the cadaver.
Yeah, you were the straw that broke his back.
Ah, turns out we already know this person, and we've got their fingerprint.
What type was hers? Jay?
Yeah, this must be someone we found out from employment records in an earlier case.
Yeah. No, Annabelle was the one that wrote the sorry email.
Was she? I don't think she was.
I wrote it down on this. It says Annabelle, sorry email.
Oh. Well, there you go.
And that's why I keep notes.
I'm sorry to hear you got yakisoba pan in your face.
Weird.
Okay, no obvious murder weapon, but there's bloodstains leading over here.
What?
And we found some synth beef. What's that doing there?
From the food that you threw. Ah, God. Snake in the Garden, €2. Don't know because it's the funniest post-CP. More indie, please.
I think someone's been rifling through this place.
Oh, God. What's that? Count backwards from four, is it? Is it eight?
Yeah.
A lot of people.
Ooh,
with the
a
same
sync disc.
Huh.
I'll have that.
Nice. Oh, a bunch of them.
Well, I guess we should do some police work.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right. That's what we were doing. Not covering up our murder.
Okay, Hannibal Dobson's prints are on the safe. As much to be expected, really. Oh, fingerprint type O.
It's the first time we've seen this one. Okay. Assuming the fingerprints...
It might be Mr. Yakisoba Pan's fingerprints.
We never printed him.
Well, there wasn't much time to do that after I panned him in the face.
Yeah. Oh, that'd be weird. Can I have your fingerprints?
Yes. Konstantin Bondarenko is this person's live-in friend.
Okay. It all makes sense now.
Okay.
Yeah. You know what this means, Yahtzee? We'll have to do this for free to clear your name.
It's classic noir, isn't it?
No.
Oh, she works the Salty Laborer Grill as well. Jesus. I guess that's why we already know who they are. Everything comes through the Salty Laborer Grill.
Yep. It's a front.
All right.
Wait, what's that written on the walls there? In blood, I think. What? Ad paid.
Ad paid?
What? Paid ad.
Well, if you don't like paid ads, you won't like the escapist content much.
No.
There's that typo fingerprint again.
Yeah. Do you think there's just fingerprints A through Z?
Once you go through all the letters of the alphabet, it starts going to AA and then AB and then AC.
Oh, oof, never mind.
Yeah. Huh. Did we search them properly? I'll search them again.
Probably not.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We found out the wound was caused by a blade.
Yeah.
I'm suspicious about this bloodstain that's been dragged across the room.
Okay.
Why is there synth beef on the floor?
Oh, no. Inspect it. Not suitable for vegetarians. Do you think she brought it from work?
Oh, I don't need this hot dog anymore.
Still have a hot dog. The
Go away.
Hot dog. Oh, God. Yeah, that's not going to help clear our name at all. They're going to find our DNA.
More type O fingerprints on the synth beef.
Yeah.
Well, the fact that it's here makes me wonder if we shouldn't check the fridge. Maybe the perp has been raiding the refrigerator, amongst other things.
We've got synth beef and a knife. Yeah, I'm thinking fridge. Hello, hello, what's this?
Annabelle Dobson. Oh, fairy bread.
Fairy bread, what?
Was the creator of this game Australian?
I don't know, I didn't ask.
Do you know what fairy bread is?
No.
It's Australian party food. You take a piece of shitty white bread, shitty sliced white bread, like Wonder Bread, you put butter on it, and then you sprinkle on rainbow sprinkles. And that's it.
Oh. It's like a very sad cupcake.
Yes. It's budget confectionery.
Yeah.
Or the Australian on a budget.
Yeah, I guess they were Australian. So it's just Annabelle Dobson and a bunch of type O, whoever that might be.
I'm willing to bet type O is Konstantin.
So?
Ow! Don't stop shooting me, officer. Ow!
When was the last time we saved? Bloody hell. Dun, dun, dun. It's the plot, she thickens. Well, we don't know where he is because we chased him out of where he lives. We put him into a rage. He killed someone and ran.
In my experience, if like someone's been killed who's got like a live-in partner, the partner is always mysteriously absent.
Right. I go here. Well, we know where Konstantin works at the Adore Group.
Yes. Oh. I think we haven't yet humiliated Konstantin.
We can alter the timeline.
Now we can relive this moment.
Alright. It'll be so funny if she answers the door this time. We're in some kind of alternate universe now. You're not coming.
Oh, I think we might have fucked up the game's coding because I saved, like, after I knocked on the door.
So now we have to break in and slap him with it.
And now the game's confused because the Oh, hang on.
Oh, he's coming now.
Are you coming?
Oh, just sleep.
There he is. I got something for you.
Camera.
Actually, I don't think I needed to.
Sure.
I think the first time I did this quest, I had to take a picture, but I think that's like a side objective.
Okay.
I think in this case, yeah, it's all resolved.
Alrighty then.
Tee-hee. Now I'm wondering if the same murder's going to come up again.
Yeah, I don't know. It'll be interesting. So that would mean the world is essentially seeded, isn't it?
Yeah.
Which kind of could be interesting.
Yeah, yeah.
Share your seed with other people in a non-creepy way. Lovely. All right. Okay, I wonder if it'll still give the same cases before then. It almost makes a conundrum. We know that a murder's about to happen. What if we just stake him out?
Let's try this one.
What's this?
It's another theft one.
Alrighty. Rare disc. Oh, dang, that's right. There were rare discs there. Alright, last one we go here. Nice quote, Frost. Which bit?
The seed part, I think.
Oh. Don't write that down.
Is this solved graphic going to go away at any point?
Maybe.
Oh, there we
once
go.
You, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Imperial, okay. We go to Gelden with the $5. This was a fast 115 minutes. Thanks for the recommendation. This game looks great.
Well, I'm glad I've brought that across.
And highlighted Lazarus. Apparently the developer is from Cardiff.
Really? Not Australia?
Hmm.
Or is there a Cardiff in Australia?
What if they were in England and then went to Australia?
Well, that would be a popular route, as I understand it. I think a lot of very handsome people do that.
Do they? Oh, what happened there, old hunter? What'd you do? Ah, there you go.
Okay. No, I just
old hunter, $77.99. Games like this are more fun to watch than AAA. There you go. I agree. Games that give you the room for narrative to just unfold in front of you. It's like watching a baby being born.
Yeah, like the Nemesis system, as like we were saying earlier.
Yeah,
which nice to just set some
away.
Rules in place and let people fill in the blanks themselves. Okay. Now go away, briefcase. You are no longer needed.
It's a good thing the game has its own, like, information tracking system.
Okay, let's see what we've got this time. Well, we know where they live. We have we have their fingerprint. Their first name initial is A, and they work in Conte Parks. Well, that's a lot more to work on.
Yep.
Thank you, game. In fact, the envelope we're looking for might even just be at Conte Parks.
See, I imagine those harder cases are the ones that you take as you progress, like, so much that all of the missing information is easier to fill in.
Well, I think it's fun to try to think of creative ways to solve them like that. Like I've mentioned in my review, the one time all I had was a phone number. So I had to break into a building and access the phone records and deduce what building the phone call went to and then narrow down the list of people with the same first initial.
Yeah, we haven't done that yet.
Oh, we've only been given the building. We don't actually know the workplace.
Oh,
Conte
God.
Parks is the entire building.
Nah.
Well, that's a lot harder to figure out.
And you can do it in 2 minutes.
Probably not.
Just the mailbox pick is a just, mailbox at random.
Are the mailboxes just apartment numbers or are workplaces listed here as well? Well, it looks like this is mostly an apartment building.
Yeah. Well, some of the businesses are in the middle of apartment buildings.
Yeah. And sometimes I don't know if it's a coding fucker, but sometimes people's home addresses are listed as their workplaces.
Yeah.
Maybe that's intentional because they work from home. Yeah, this is going to be confusing. And we don't really have time to pursue it anyway. Oh, well.
Random guess.
I like to think we've done enough to demonstrate why this game is a lot of fun. For people like you and me, who like pretending to be private detectives.
Yeah. There's room for creativity, imagination. And like I said, if you like writing things down, tons of fun for that.
And you can create little story moments where you just sort of have to fill in some blanks for yourself.
That's going to be a thing.
Imagine how that person must have felt after we'd thrown yakisoba pan in his face and run away. What would have been going through his mind as he slowly closed his front door and contemplated an evening spent washing tomato sauce out of his shirt? Did he regret his path in life? Did he then go on and murder his girlfriend?
And it was all because of us. See, I could see someone starting an entire either Twitch channel or YouTube channel where it is just emergent stories that came through in a game like this.
I think that's exactly what this game is shooting for, emergent stories.
There you go.
Have we got devs in chat? There's someone in Twitch saying glad you all enjoyed it, but they just could be a fan.
No, that's just Henry. Good old Henry. Mr. Dayfox is here. He's friends of the dev.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I remembered that. I thought maybe he'd called his friend and had him come and watch. We did get retweeted today by the devs.
Lovely.
So, they didn't know I was doing it. Well, anyway, thanks for watching the post-CP stream, everyone. If you want to see my review of Shadows of Doubt, which unusually I reviewed while it was still in early access, you can go to escapismagazine.com and see it there. You can watch it on YouTube in a week's time, or you can watch it on YouTube now if you're a YouTube member or a premium subscriber, and why wouldn't you be, honestly? I was Yahtzee Crucial. I was joined by Frost.
Had a good old time. It's amazing.
He's that guy right there. And what else have I got? I've got an extra punctuation dropping for members tomorrow, so if you're a member, you can enjoy that. Otherwise, you'll have to wait till next week. What else have we got today? I think later today we've got the breakout stream, and even later than that, we've continuing getting Jesse to play God of War in Get Jesse to the Greek.
Oh, yep.
Anything you need to plug?
The usual, The Cold Takes Out, the untitled pilot to a new series. Have a look at that. Little pizza tower, little game demos. All a good time as I go and work on the other stuff.
All right. Well, I guess that'll be it from us then. Let's have the prerequisite dog exposure. Here he is.
Was Toffee there the whole time?
Yep, just having a little kip in my jacket, and he's very annoyed that I've woken him up.
Oh.
All right. See you all next time. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah, you shake it out.